Alright guys, so look what I did. I made the oak wood stairs, upside down stairs, and I was originally thinking, well, I could take some half slabs like this one right here, and I could totally do something like this, right? And it would totally get rid of the space that leads out, you know? I could totally do something like this, but I don't know. I'm not quite sold on this idea of like making it look like that. I actually like it without it. It kind of creates like a little vent system. Because if you think about sawmills, they have a lot of sawdust. And where's the sawdust realistically going to go? I think that's one right there. No, not. Those are two stairs. Oh, nighttime already, huh? Well, I don't know where the sun is. It's gone somewhere. Oh, there it is. So yeah, I was just thinking, you know, and then it also creates this little step type of thing. So if I go up here, how am I going to get up there? If I go up here, you can see it actually sticks out a little ways and it creates just a little bit of a step portion thing. Although I could do that. Nah, that'd be too much. That'd be too much. But it creates this little, kind of like a step idea, just to give a little bit of an extra flavor. And if I go off to the side, you can actually see in a little ways. And I do want to go off to the side and go down here and take a quick nap. I also realized I'm going to need some cobblestone slabs, and I do think I have some, but for the time being, I'm just going to go ahead and make some. I did find some stairs, I remember that. So I have some cobblestone, just make a few slabs. I completely forgot that I could just, instead of blocking these off, I could just slab them off. And that would give me the cobblestone look up here, but it wouldn't give me that really, really bad looking thing down below. Right, so all of these right here, I could just cobblestone up. Which slabs, just to cover those up right there. Oops, yeah, that was nice. And let's just see if I can get, went too far. Went way too far, where am I? Oh, I'm at the bottom, okay. Get back up here. Because this piece of wood is sitting in a perfect place right now, and I don't want to mess that up at all. And so what I could do here is I could just get rid of this. And now it's going to look funny with those there. So, oh my goodness, okay. Come on, can I get it? No, I don't want to take that. The gravel there is not going to be a good thing. I'm going to have to replace the gravel with something else. Come on. I know I can get it. There we go. And what I can put in this place is I can put some half slab there. Where did the cobblestone go? I know I didn't get it. But yeah, I can probably stick some half slabs here. There we go, and then just cover this up with stone, and I'm going to have to go up there and figure out what happened up there. What if I just did that? Would that be bad? Not really. Still look okay, I guess. Or I could, you know, see the other thing is if I did this, it's going to have a piece that sticks out, and again, it's not going to look good. However, I could do cobblestone stairs. And I really just don't want to go down there. Oh. Yeah, see, I'm going to have to deal with this guy. Hi. Let's get you out in the sun. Yeah, you broke my sword, buddy. There we go. Okay, I'm back. Zombie. Okay. I'll explain in a second what happened. Goodness, there's everybody in here. I don't want to explore now. Oh my goodness, there's a creeper too. I'm getting out of here. Ow. Do I have any arrows? They're coming this way, really? You guys are coming this way. I have no arrows. Ow! Come on, guys. Okay, looks like I'm gonna have to do you in. Geronimo! Creeper. I see you. Okay. Just go for broke there. Yeah, it looks like one. Oh my goodness. Don't D me. I'm just gonna go this way. Thank you. Wow. Okay, the cave network looks really nice. I really like that cave network. We're not exploring it right now. We're trying to figure out how to make this work right here. Just this portion right here, you know? Oh, I do like this. This might actually work out nice. I wonder. I'll think about that. I'll see where that goes. Yeah, that what's all. Oh, see, now it's just a mess. This is just a mess. A mess, I say. This is just not gonna work. Oh, what am I gonna do here? I can't do this. But I do want it to line up to this here. So I could just get rid of it. Could be the way to go. I could just chop this tree down. Instead of putting a tree there, I could just get rid of this. Could this is just getting a just turning into a big mess right now. There. It's better now. Anyhow, now that we fixed that and got attacked and almost blown up, let's get back to the roof. The roof, we have yet to finish the roof. So let's get up here. Oh, yeah, you know I should take this out. Every stair makes a valuable difference. Every stair will make a valuable difference for me. Maybe not today, maybe not tomorrow, maybe not next week, but soon. I can't get up there. I've got all these dirt piles and none of them get me up. So, yeah. So I'm going to do exactly the same thing over here. And we're going to set this up. Not that way. This-a-way. See? Go this-a-way. Ow. I got stuck there for a second. That was just weird. Yeah, so this will actually make it break the monotony. What am I trying to say? Break the monotony a little bit. Oh, what happened, by the way? Here I am being attacked by zombies, right? And then Dog decided to go, "Hey, there's somebody at the door. I hear somebody. Go answer the door." And I'm like, I have my headphones on. I can't hear anything. Because I can't hear anything, there shouldn't be anybody at the door. So I had to go pause it because she, you know, got really upset and just made things worse. And now I gotta figure out how I'm gonna do the sawmill itself. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I got a space of 6 to work with. The 1, 2, 3, and 3. That will be the 2 center pieces. And I can essentially do it this way. Alright, so when I cut out, I actually cut out right about here. And so Dog decided to start barking up again. So I was like, you know, since you're going to keep barking, you can keep barking away. I'm just going to go get me some materials. And so I just did some inventory management here. Got myself some doors. The doors itself is going to go down here. So I'm putting in some spruce doors right about here. I'm probably going to have to take them out again. Oops. No, you don't go there. There we go. I'm probably going to have to take them out again because the ground, that's not what I want to be the ground, but just to have the doors there, you know? You can have my last torch. Could use them a little bit more space. So over in the warehouse, way over that way towards the mine, I did some work and I was trying to see what I could do with this area and how I can make it work. So polished diorite is essentially what I came up with. And it's very odd too. I'll show you why. This is diorite. This is polished diorite. This is polished diorite. This is regular diorite. Seriously, the only difference is pretty much this gray border and a few less pixelated pixels in there. Otherwise, it's pretty much identical. It's really hard to tell them apart, quite frankly. So hopefully I don't put down the wrong one. Hopefully I use polished diorite instead of the other one. So I'm gonna essentially have a table that run across here. I'm afraid, because I really want this to be 2 wide rather than 3 wide, so I'm afraid it's going to be slightly wrong, but I'm going to try. I'm going to do a little sample between the torches there, because ideally if I did it 2 wide it would be better. Now I could do something where I don't do it this way, right? I've also got some stone brick slabs. Where are you? Stone brick slabs. Don't break stairs. Don't break slabs. I had slabs in here. What did I do with the slabs? Did I put them away? Oh, there they are. Just like slabs, come back. So I've got some stone brick slabs. That's going across the top here. And in one part of this, I really want to have essentially the saw blades. And the saw blades, oh, I have some more torches. The saw blades are going to be made from this. Essentially cobblestone walls. Oh my goodness, I'm losing the word there. Cobblestone walls are essentially going to be the piece that I'm going to use for the saw blade. Now the challenge here is I'm also going to get some wood. I'm going to need way more spruce wood than this, but the spruce wood is going to go like this, right across the top. And this is where I've got some, this is where, you know, it pays actually to have the wider space, and it could work out this wide. Because now I can put something over here. I mean, I could use, for example, stone stairs as the guidepost. So that way the wood has a guidepost to go through, right, as it goes through. And I don't know, design-wise, will that look okay or not? I mean, I wish I could make it smaller and just stick a half slab sticking straight up, but that doesn't work very well, right? I could always use fence posts, but that would look also weird to do fence posts. I've got some fence posts here, and you can see what I mean. If I did fence posts, that's not a fence post. You are not a fence post. Where'd you come from, wood? There. The fence post would essentially look like this, so it wouldn't quite fit guide-wise the wood. However, it could be useful. I'm using a pickaxe for that. Yeah, so I'm also going to need some more wood coming out over here, because essentially I'm splitting the wood in half. So let me go gather a couple more spruce trees. I'll be right back. Okay, got me 27 more pieces of wood. You don't go there. Why do you keep wanting to go there? Yeah, so the wood here, right around here, is where it's going to split. So I need to have some wood split like this, so that way the wood gets cut in half. And then over here, this is where it's not going to split, see? And it's going to be one piece of wood right there. And so that's where it's going to be kind of interesting, this piece of wood right here. And I don't know how to best work that, but I guess that's the way to go, right? Stick this there. And maybe I could do this. Let's try something. Push the wood out that way, maybe? I don't know. No, but see, that would be weird, because if it goes straight through the blade, it would actually come out over here. Or I could do this, actually. Turn the wood. But then again, the wood would look weird. It's getting dark again. If I turn the wood, or if I put the wood here, actually. Yeah, there it goes. That could work. That could actually work right there. Anyways, let me go take a nap, and I'm going to go figure that part out. I don't exactly know how that's going to turn out. Yeah, so let me expand this out a little ways, a little bit more. Polished diorite. Here we are. Because again, remember I said there was going to be a ramp going down this way? And essentially, what's going to happen here is you're going to have log come over here. Logs are essentially going to come up this, go up the bank and then up this ramp over here. And then somehow they've got to fit in there, right? So if I've got the space right here, they're going to essentially fit right into here, get cut. And actually they should be getting cut this way, but I can also drag the logs from over there up a ramp over here. Oh, now there are leaves. I will take my saplings now. Thank you very much. Yeah, so I can always drag the log piles from over here, drag them through the woods a little way, and then come up the ramp on this side, and that could always work. So I'll see how that can play out. And if they come up the ramp, they would essentially be one big giant log laying right here, and then you could swing that log out this way, and it could be fairly balanced, and then it'd pop out on the table. So let's move the table maybe here. That way it doesn't extend too far, you know? Oops, that went too far. Yeah, about there. That could do. And let's leave this open, and I'm gonna put back the, where are you? Labs, there you are. need some more stone slabs. But yeah, we'll put the stone slabs here. Yeah, I think it'd be fine to leave this open as it is, because that's where the saw blade will go. And I would like to know where the saw blade actually goes, actually, because it would be kind of cool to have something on the bottom. Yeah, so the wood would essentially pop out this way. This is where you would cut the wood. The wood would then split right about here. And one piece of wood would come this way, while the other piece of wood would go that way. And as you cut them, you can eventually turn the side and, you know, shrink them a little bit. And then we can always have, you know, piles of wood just kind of laying around here. Already pre-cut wood. Oh, thank goodness. Skeleton down there too, I see him. Let's go tear down my giant dirt pillar, because I don't think I need this one anymore. But yeah, I think this is turning out quite well now. Sawmill's looking good. You're already a piece of cut wood. I'll leave you there for now. Let's go way over there into the mountains. I'm just curious. Wow, tree grew real quick. I'm just curious what it looks like now. There's a staircase area somewhere right around there. Up, 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 all the way up. We can't really see the actual sawmill section unless I go down this way a little ways. There it goes. Yeah, that's looking out real good. I like this. And I do want to maybe put a little border here. I don't know if I want to use oak wood or what, but dark oak would be super nice if I can border this whole thing in dark oak, but I don't think that's going to happen. So oak is all I got, and or I can use birch, but birch might be a little bit too bright for something like this. I don't know. We'll have to see. There's going to be a piece that hangs over like this. So that way, right here, it's going to have fence posts, and I'm going to need way more spruce trees, of course. The whole thing's going to be ringed by fence posts, not all over, but just in certain areas. If I did the cobblestone, it would end up being like this, but I don't think I can put fence posts on cobblestone stairs. So let's try that. I don't remember if I can do that. Let's borrow the fence post. Where are you? There you are. I took a moment to put together some wood. Let's see, can I get the fence post up there? If I can, then I'll probably do the cobblestone stairs because they're awesome up down stairs. Oh, I can. Oh, good. Yeah, so maybe that'll work better because I really don't want this flat thing right here. I'd rather have it look like this. Mess that up, didn't I? Well, anyways, then up here, I don't know. I could always cap this off. Ooh, free trees. Yay, free trees. I can always use that. But yeah, I can always cap this off with some of this. Not cobblestone slabs. Where are you? There you are. With actual stone bricks. I don't know if that will look good. Let's try. Will that look nice? Yeah, that actually could look pretty nice. Now the only question is, or I could use stone brick stairs. Excuse me. You're not part of planting season, buddy. You gotta stay way over there. We don't like you. You are not invited to planting season, Mr. Creeper. I'm gonna take my stuff. I needed bread. That's why I came over here. I didn't invite you here, you know. Where are you, Creeper? What can I do with you? I'm gonna ruin my field. Oh my goodness. Okay, let's go over here. No, I missed. Oh, that was horrible. Over here, buddy. Alright, let's go out and get him. Get as far away from my field as possible. Hey, over here! Oh, why am I even trying to hit you over there? There we go. He's gone now. Okay, back to work. Hey, zombie friend. Do you want to tell him the good news? I got tons of stone now. Stone bricks. Also, when I got my andesite, so I can change out the bottom with andesite. So, let's start by putting in some stone bricks. The upside down staircase. And let's just take a look. Because it may actually work to have this little, you know, stylized thing. So, let's just see. I mean, I can always move it up if I need to. Oh wait, this is not gonna go. This won't need anything. Cool, lucky me. I mean, I want this to be low-hanging right here. I want cobblestone to be in this thing. And now I'm kind of wondering, should I take out that extra cobblestone and put some random, like, dirt or something? We'll just do the front, and let's see what it looks like. I also picked up some wood. I was thinking I could put fence posts like this, going across the top this way. However, if we opt to do it the other way, that would essentially be doing it this way, where I got, and we'll just take a look at this. If I opt to do it the other way, I would end up having this slabs overhanging a little bit more like this, versus it being sitting on top like that. So I mean, they're two different styles, they both work, but which one works better is the question. Let's go up one more at least. And so I could actually do the fence post this away. Oh, weird. Oh, that's why. Hello. It's like, what happened there? Anyways, I could also do the fence post this way, because that would give me at least two cobblestones to work with, as opposed to just a single cobblestone. Yeah, I think that could work. It could give me the style I'm looking for. It'll make it a little bit bigger looking, and the roof will still be smaller. So let's go up to this hillside here. That may actually do nicely. I don't know about the second piece of wood in front. I think I might just tear it out. I don't know. Well, I'm still thinking about it. But yeah, I think that makes it look nice. Let's get some andesite on the bottom of that, and I think it'll look really good after that. Of course, what I could also do is change the depth height as I go around the building. So we'll see. I will take the trees. Thank you very much. Yeah, I'm actually trying to get a tree to grow just right to where it's like the leaves go right up against the wall. That's what I would really like to do if I could make that happen. Stairs. Could some depth could actually work here to change the height level of various things, and that would actually create a nice nifty little thing, because this is going to be a ramp right here, so it would be nice if this went down some like this, and that actually will work fine. And let me put some slabs at least here and here, and here and here and here and here, of course, right? Okay, so let's see what happens when this thing grows. I actually made a little forest here apparently by planting a little too much, but no, this is actually perfect. This is what I want, something like a foresty type environment here. Oh cool, I made it up though. I accidentally just overdid that. Slap my way over here. I'm still not sure about this being a ramp or not, but we're gonna make one anyhow. And that'll be fine for the time being. Get rid of this. Oh, you know what? Oh, I'm gonna have to take out my wood again. This is like perfect up until I did this. There it goes. So that's gonna be much more the height I'm looking for right there for everything else. Except for this piece, it's gonna be that high. So let's get in. I'm gonna be right back. I'm gonna go ahead and put in some of the other stone brick stairs. Like that. And I go, oh no, I'm stuck. Help. I got stuck in there. Oh, well, shoot. I should have done the andesite while I was there. Yeah, that's actually going to be kind of nice. It's just part of the terrain. I'm essentially working with the terrain as it is. There's no point to change the terrain, per se. And I'd rather just keep the terrain as natural looking as possible, just so, you know, everything meshes up well. And then we're going to have to change this. This is going to take a while. So let me cut out here. I'm going to cut this off, and we're going to put some andesite down here and some more stone bricks everywhere else. Okay, I'll be right back. I moved this up. Oops, I forgot to put the fence post in. Oh my goodness.